churches, black churches. Different people, same hearses. It's kind of hard to fight with each other. Laying down on the ground, 600. At every show, I see my people. They ain't the same, but they're all equal. One love, one God, one family.
Who is it? The Honourable Ahmed Hussen, Minister of Housing, Diversity and Inclusion, born January 1, 1978, Mogadishu, Somalia. Why they were chosen. Ahmed Hussen was elected for the Art-Based Raising Awareness Project as he represents a Canadian who has been victim to systemic racism here in Ontario, which is so close for many of us taking part in this course. Where did you get the source? I was able to obtain the source from a TED Talk on YouTube. It is titled, Two Canadas, My Story of Generosity and Systemic Racism. It was accessed on January 25th, 2023, and is available at the following link. Other sources on a similar topic included Reuben Carter, also known as the Hurricane, the 16th round from number one contender to number 45,472. I was also going to elect James White, who was an Air Force veteran, and he speaks on 50 years of racism that he's experienced. And another source on a different topic included that of Chanel Miller, her book Know My Name, a memoir. What issues of oppression or social justice are present in your source? The oppression faced by Ahmed Hussen is that of racism. However, racism is not simply the prejudiced views and acts of an individual, but is part of a broader system of inequality and oppression that is not only built into the social fabric, it also routinely shapes and affects the everyday life experiences of racialized people. Dumbrell-Lenny, 2019. There is some form of social justice where Ahmed Hussen is able to use his political platform to assist visible minorities and bring back life to the communities that need such assistance. He was able to obtain a $500 million fund to help revitalize Regent Park in Toronto, which is known as a rough part of the city, also representing a large population of black people. What created the oppression, social injustices in the person's life? Anti-black racism began in Canada during the transatlantic slave trade era. There has since been a long history of black people having less rights than white Europeans, which bleeds into the biases shaped today. Privilege also contributes to the continued oppression and social injustices. The very structures and systems in place working against black people, illustrated by higher incarceration rates and while being three times more likely to come from a low-income family opposed to white Europeans. Racial profiling, derogatory comments, and mistaken identity, in addition to the various forms of microaggressions, were experienced by Ahmed Hussen. The internalized inequality this bears on the individual must be accounted for as well. Microaggressions are brief and constant verbal, behavioral, or environmental indignities, whether intentional or unintentional, that communicate hostile, derogatory, or negative slights or insults. Ives and Others, 2020. What connection does it have with broader social systems? It demonstrates that there is a need for great change, as the systems in place to serve the citizens of this nation are actually biased against certain populations, and the race line is clear. Has it been addressed? Racism continues to be an issue today. However, there has been progress and greater social awareness surrounding this form of oppression. February is known as Black History Month, and institutions such as Nipissing University, Sure, there's support through various social awareness campaigns and through workshops. How is it addressed? There were occasions in which systemic racism was addressed, as Ahmed Hussen alluded to programs and supports that he was able to access to pursue a higher education, providing a better life for himself with respect to future financial success through an educational system that is often acting against visible minorities, especially those who are Black. Was, is more needed? There is a constant need for greater education and awareness. In addition to addressing the systemic systems in place that continue to contribute towards the suppression of visible minorities, the same need is required at a micro level, for which we must all check our unconscious biases to avoid consciously or unconsciously contributing towards microaggressions that also continue to perpetuate the cycle of racism. How does this topic narrative speak to you? The narrative provides me with a greater understanding regarding the continued suppression faced by visible minorities. The topic resonates with me as I have empathy for visible minorities and the hardship they have faced by those deemed privileged. What did you take away from the topic? That Black Canadians continue to be overrepresented in the prison system and are 3 times more likely to be in a low-income household. That acts of support opposed to microaggressions will have a direct impact on development. Social workers can advocate for systems and supports that will ensure Black people simply have an equal opportunity to take part in society. Did you learn anything new? How overwhelmingly present systemic racism is within our society today. Anything surprising? It was extremely difficult to listen to acts of racism from members of parliament when Ahmed Hussen was acting as a political staffer. Furthermore, recounting his case not being called up under the assumption that he was one of the accused in the courtroom rather than the lawyer for a defendant reaffirms the unconscious biases people have to this day. How did this project have you reflect on your own biases? The project made me realize how much more work is still required within Canada to address systemic racism. It is often thought of as an issue more predominant with our neighbors to the south, but it is apparent that our past history is still embedded in the very fabric of our society today. How does this topic narrative speak to you? The narrative depicted a stark reality that I had not truly accepted and or realized was a reality for so many. Do you empathize with the source? I have great empathy for the source and Black individuals as a whole, as the oppression faced by this population is embedded in a nation that is often perceived as innocent and just. Thoughtfulness in connecting to the art to the source. It was imperative that the story of one nation was depicted through the lens of a Black individual. Therefore, it was important to use something that would symbolize systemic racism, but also allowed for the opportunity to display the vibrant beauty of our nation and the many races within it. Art-based Raising Awareness Project. This is my piece that I've decided to create, which is a representation of my first person source and the systemic racism that he has experienced, as well as the generosity and love that he's also experienced from citizens within Canada. Thoughtfulness in connecting the art to the oppression, social injustice. By depicting half of the Canadian flag in black and white, I wanted to clearly demonstrate that racism is still embedded in the fabric of Canadian society at the macro level, which inherently spreads into both the meso and micro levels. The art reflects empathy. It is believed that the art piece reflects a sense of empathy for several reasons. It was important to depict a nation viewed through the lens of the oppressed, illustrating a society that can be inclusive to all, but also the reality of a nation that is still embedded with racism. However, by using a frame that was natural and unaltered, I wanted to further demonstrate the beauty of an object before it is shaped by any biases. Similar to the frame, if we strip ourselves down and check our own unconscious biases, we can help eradicate racism, which is a message reciprocated by Ahmed Hussen. As for the abstract, the first person narrative I elected to use was the Honourable Ahmed Hussen, Minister of Housing, Diversity and Inclusion. The oppression faced throughout his life is that of systemic racism. Therefore, the art medium used was a painting depicting a Canadian flag to demonstrate that racism is embedded in the fabric of our nation through black and white. However, it was equally as important to represent the other part of Canadian society built upon a diverse group of people and illustrate that we are capable of a bright future which can be inclusive to all. A significant statement that I derived from the project is one of hope and how the same systems used to suppress black people can be used in an anti-oppressive manner to help break the cycle of racism which has plagued this group of people for far too long. Through my project, I hope that the audience is able to gain greater awareness regarding the prevalence of racism in our society today, and by also checking our own biases in order to work towards greater inclusiveness.